शांति।
ओम शांति।
एवरीबॉडी कैन हियर मी?
यस
यस।
गुड। कम इनटू द सिटिंग पोस्चर। कीप योर बैक नेक स्ट्रेट। बी कंफर्टेबल। रिलैक्स। Gently close your eyes. Go into your posture, go into your asana. Now very slowly bring your awareness towards inhalation and exhalation. Inhale and exhale. Now, take a deep, prolonged inhalation, deep, prolonged exhalation, Purak Rechak. Inhale slowly, deeply. Exhale slowly, completely. Now, prepare yourself for the three time I'm chanting. Take a deep, prolonged, slow inhalation. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Feel the vibration and sensation. Join your both palm, rub your palm. Now very slowly place on your eyes when you're rubbing your palm. feel the warmness. And gently, while looking at your palm, open up your eyes with a great smile. Om Shanti to all. So all of you can hear me, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, in previous session, we talked about it, the pranayama. Till now, we discuss about the Sheetli, Sheetkari, Bhastrika, and also pre-practice Kapalbhati, Nadi Shodhan. All the pranayama, we talked about it, then Surabhidi, Chandrabhidi. Now today we're going to learn the very important pranayama, that is Ujjayi, which is very much popular in modern world also, especially as Ashtanga Vinyasa flow. Many teachers, even those who are teaching the Ashtanga Vinyasa, they introduce the Ujjayi breath when you are doing the Ashtanga Vinyasa flow. That play very important role, Ujjayi. So I think everybody is familiar of this word, Ujjayi. So Ujjayi pranayam, today we're going to learn about it. I'll write it down for you. The spelling, Ujjayi. Pranayama. Which means, if we're gonna go with the literal meaning, so Uddha means Ud plus G. You can separate this prefix Ud plus G, Ujjayi. So prefix is Ud plus G. Ud means bondage, binding element, or upward or expanding. And J means victorious, or G, Ujjayi, which means victorious, conqueror. So literal meaning of Ujjayi means breath of victory or victorious breath. Or one who is victorious, who has the capability to conquer the world, to gain the mastery or to become the master. That is a literal meaning of the Ujjayi. Coming out all kind of bondage when you become the master. So master of what? You are becoming the master of something. It means you are breaking the bondage. You are more free than the other person. So when we talked about getting the ultimate freedom, then you become the master of your body, master of your mind. So Jai Pranayam, the meaning itself, you know, telling the benefit of a Jai Pranayam. By practicing the Jai Pranayam, you become the master over of your mind. You can conquer the five senses. So pratyahar, by practicing this Ujjayi pranayam, you are practicing the pratyahar, conquering, withdrawing from the five senses and becoming your own master, master of the mind. So Ujjayi is basically working on the balance, bringing the balance to your body, bringing the balance to the mind. It's bring more calm, focused, and make you more varied kind of quality. It will give you the more varied kind of quality. You are more confident, more, you know, taking the risk, more have the quality of the leader. You overcome your fatigueness, stress, or depression by just practicing it. You energize, increase the prana in your body. So Ujjayi breath is so give you the most tremendous benefit, and very simple breath. It's another name of Ujjayi, ocean breath also. Ocean breath, because when you are practicing Ujjayi breath, you make the sound of ocean through your throat. It's mentioned in many Asian texts, the benefit of the Ujjayi breath, Ujjayi pranayam. By practicing Ujjayi breath, you slow down the pace of your breathing pattern, and which improve your lifespan. It cleans most of the nadis, energy channels, and improve your prana, promotes the mental clarity and make you more focused, and also improvise your immune system. It working on your autonomic nervous system. So parasympathetic and sympathetic system both ways. Same time you're getting the energy, but same time you are calming yourself. So parasympathetic and sympathetic system, you're bringing the balance between two. Till in previous class, we are learning how you can cool down. You are working on the one system at one time, like Chandra Bhedi Pranayam working the parasympathetic system, where Surya Bhedi Pranayam working on the sympathetic system. But here, you're working in both system together, all together, simultaneously. Both systems are working in the balanced way. It promotes the sound sleep. If somebody feeling the lack of, you know, they don't fall into the sleep easily. So it promotes the sleep also. And people who snore a lot, right? Many people, they snore a lot while sleeping. It's helped to reduce their snoring also. And it's very good in thyroid problem, hyper and hypo. Both thyroid problems would be sorted out when they are practicing. Also, it helps to control high blood pressure and cardiovascular related problems would be cured when you are practicing Ujjayi breath. So, tremendous benefit of the Ujjayi breath, spiritual, yes. As I keep talking about it, pranayam, it can lead you towards the Kundalini awaken also, balancing your chakras also. But I don't want to talk about those things because it's too early to talk about your getting the spiritual benefit, because first we have to make our body physically and psychologically healthy, and then we can enter into the spiritual benefit. Yes, Anka.
Sir, about the this pranayam promotes the sound sleep, right? So actually, I have a particular problem. I get sound sleep, but I get too many dreams. So is this pranayam helps or any other pranayam to reduce the dreams? Actually, even if I sleep for 1 or 2 hours, I get dreams. So
what kind of dreams you get? Nightmares?
Not nightmares, but like daily I get dreams. Even if I sleep for 1-2 hours, like when I was going for a job, that time was when 1 hour journey in the bus also I was getting dreams. So like it's a lot of dreams, but not nightmare, but just that too many dreams. But the sleep is sound like even if I sleep for 6-7 hours, I feel fresh in the morning. But a lot of dreams. So I just wanted to know that is any pranayam that can help me.
Of course, all the pranayam gonna help you to reduce your dreams, because why you see the dreams? Because your mind is still active. You think a lot, right? Always you are thinking. That's why you get, and you're thinking when you are awake, that time you are thinking, and when you are sleeping, you're going for sleep. You're not stopping your brain. And through the dream, that thinking is keep going because you make the habit of thinking, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think a lot, right? You think all the time. So immediately you want to think about it and you go about to go for sleep. You didn't, you know, channelize yourself into the something else, that by doing the practice of meditation or even by little bit practice of pranayam. So your mind little bit calm down. So if you... any kind of pranayam, not only the ujjayi, but any kind of pranayam or any simple breathing which channelize your mind, which at least give you a little bit break from the thinking. You divert your energy. So there's a high chance where you're going to reduce the dream, and also maybe you don't get the dream. You get the perfect sound sleep. You get the dream because you are thinking too much. So we cannot stop thinking, right? I cannot tell you, okay, don't think, it cannot be possible. Okay. So what we're gonna channelize our mind into the different direction. So you can do the anapan. Remember first class of meditation, you learn the anapan meditation, that you can do while traveling anywhere, because maybe pranayam is not good when you're practicing in the public or traveling somewhere, right? But anapan meditation, you can practice anywhere, anytime, no matter where you are traveling, where you are, you have company or not. So do the practice of anapan and it's going to help you. But if you are at home, you can go with the, any kind of pranayam or pre-practice of the pranayam.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So, ujjayi breath.
Sorry, one more thing here.
Yeah.
Does the dreams actually harm the quality of sleep, or because sorry for asking this for a long time, like, but because I don't feel any harm, like any tiredness after waking up. So I just wanted to know that dreams just harm the quality of sleep, or just same actually.
Depend person to person. If it's affecting your sleep and it's affecting your physical body, or if it's affecting your mental body, then there's a harm. But if it's not affecting, it's okay. But you want to reduce it, right? You don't want to see the many dreams. Yes, everybody wants to see the dreams which end with the happy note, right? Which give you all the things which you cannot achieve in your day-to-day activity. That dreams you will see it, so you feel lovely about it. But dreams is out of our control, right? Don't see those dreams. Sometimes it's bad, sometimes it's good. Mix-up dream you will get. So it shows that you think a lot. That is the only thing. Sometimes you get the good thoughts. Sometimes you get the bad thoughts. But we cannot discriminate that, okay, this is the good thought, so we have to keep thinking about it. What is the use of thinking about the good thoughts if you're not putting into the action, right? You're... Mm-hmm. your mind is still working, right? We are talking about giving the rest to the mind. That's it. Yogi doesn't think about the good or the bad thing. Okay. I'll give you the simple example. The people who are practicing on, they reach the highest stage of the yoga, they don't discriminate their action on the basis of good or the bad. Okay. They just stop. They just stop. That's why I keep telling yogi does nothing. So they're giving the whole pause to their mind. Okay, don't think about it. Whatever action is coming, they're performing it. Whatever task they are, you know, like I've given you some task. Okay, you have to clean the house. You have to cook the food. So without thinking, you have to just do it. Could you do this thing? No, because you are habitual of thinking. You think first, oh, why she is giving me this task? It's not related. This is not my job. You keep thinking about it. And then later on, okay, I have to do it. So you did it. So before even putting into the action, you think so much, which you don't require it. That's we have to stop. It doesn't mean that all the thinking you're going to stop, but the extra thoughts, which is not related to your activity at all, we gonna control that thing, which you don't require at all. So it's giving you more stress. Eventually, it give you more burden to your mind. That's all about.
Okay, thank you so much.
Welcome. So, yes, come back to the topic, Ujjayi. So Jay have these kind of benefit. If somebody is having the thyroid issue, snoring issue, they can practice the Ujjayi. Any precaution? No, all the people can practice the Ujjayi breath. There's no major precaution. Yes, but it increases the heat of the body, but in moderation. It's also calming down the system. So everybody can practice. It's also work on the hypertension and cardiovascular issues. People can also practice. Though it increases the activity of the body, increase the activity of the mind, and same time, cooling down the body and cooling down the mind. So both ways working, it's bringing the balance to the body, bringing the balance to the mind. So Ujjayi breath, there's no major precaution. Everybody can practice. And in all kind of weather, one can practice. Yes, best time, if you want to do the Ujjayi breath with your asana practice, any vinyasa ashtanga flow or ashtanga vinyasa flow or hatha flow, you can introduce to your student during practice your asana, or you can end your asana practice with the Ujjayi breath also, because it infused immediately, give you instant energy. So, which energy you required for maintaining and keep practicing the flow. So also you can introduce like that. Asan, again, Siddhasan, Padmasan, Vajrasan, Swastikasan, and Sukhasan. These asan are ideal for practicing the Ujjayi breath. But also you can, like in Ashtanga Vinyasa, you do the in downward dog. Yes. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward dog, downward facing dog, you practice the Ujjayi breath. That asana also you can practice. But in pranayama, in asana, you can introduce in the movement also. But when you are practicing as a pranayama, you have to do in the sitting posture. So we're going to start the practice of the Ujjayi breath. Any doubt till here? So we're going to talked about the technique now. Any doubt to him? Good. So let's come to the technique. So I'll told you that it's more like ocean breath. So understand, whenever you inhale, you have to inhale through your nose and exhale through your nose also, right? But when you inhale through your nostril, both nostril, you have to contract your throat. So larynx, your larynx part would be controlled by So contraction happen when you inhaling, contraction happen in your throat area, and it's make the sound of like this, like phas nahi atak jata gale mein, थोड़ा गर गर की आवाज आता है, ऐसा साउंड आएगा. ओशन वाला भी आएगा. और इट्स गिव यू मोर साउंड लाइक अ स्नोरिंग ऑफ द बेबी, लिटिल स्नोरिंग ऑफ द बेबी, और वेव ऑफ द ओशन व्हेन यू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट द थ्रोट. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू शो द ऑफ ऑनलाइन. But understand, when you inhale, you have to contract the throat area, the larynx, the sound box area where the sound is coming. Kant, jo jisko hum kant bolte hain, usko contract karna, wo squeeze hoga slightly. To jab wo squeeze hoga, to ek awaaz si gharshan hoga, gale mein ek gharshan hoga, jo sound nikalega, bahut halka sound nikalta hai, aur wo sound स्नोरिंग ऑफ द बेबी का होगा. जैसे बच्चे छोटे बच्चे सोते वक्त स्नोर करते हैं, और या तो ओशियन का साउंड होगा, जो वेव ओशियन वेव का साउंड होता है वैसा होगा. एंड अगेन व्हेन यू एक्सहेल, सिंपली यू हैव टू एक्सहेल. सो वी आर लर्निंग द वन टेक्निक ऑफ द उज्जयी ब्रेथ. देयर इज अदर वेरिएशन ऑफ द उज्जयी ब्रेथ, बट वी आर गोना लर्न द बेसिक वेरिएशन, फर्स्ट वेरिएशन ऑफ द उज्जयी ब्रेथ. Understand, when you're inhaling, the air goes into your lungs, and make sure the three lobes, okay, three lobes of the lungs, left and the right. So left side of the lungs having the two lobe, and right side of the lungs having the three lobe. So all the lungs would be, you know, completely, the part of the lungs completely filled, rib cage completely expanded, and diaphragm slightly moves towards the belly. When you inhale, air goes into your lungs, and same time you are, the sound is coming from the throat area. The trick is little bit difficult to understand, but it's come automatically when you feel the contraction when you inhale. So this is the one variation of the Ujjayi breath. Do you understand, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So let's start practicing it. Come into the comfortable position. Just try to see it. And if still you don't understand, you can ask the question later on. And I'll show you the video of the Ujjayi breath. In the WhatsApp group, you're gonna practice it, but don't force yourself. That's completely fine. Just follow that. So come into the sitting posture. Keep your back neck straight, perfectly aligned. Go into your posture, gently close your eyes, keep your palm on the knee. Any comfortable sitting posture you can choose, and merge with your posture. Now bring your awareness towards inhalation and exhalation. Take a deep, prolonged inhalation, deep, prolonged exhalation. Now, take a deep, prolonged, slow inhalation, deep, prolonged, slow exhalation. Do a little bit chest breathing so you can prepare yourself for the Ujjayi breath. Before practicing the Ujjayi, just go with the chest breathing. Inhale, air goes into your lungs, expansion happens. Exhale, contraction happen in your lungs, in your rib cage. Exhale completely. Inhale, exhale. Keep practicing. Now, exhale completely. Now, this time you're inhaling. As you inhale, contract your throat. Very slowly inhale. Deep, slow, prolonged inhalation you should take. And same time, contract your throat. If you can listen, so listen to me, this kind of sound will come. You can even use your right and left hand to check the vibration of your throat area. So when you're inhaling, slightly your throat, your larynx would be vibrated and makes little sound which automatically coming when you contracted your throat and inhaling. When you exhale, relax your throat muscles, relax your face muscles, your tongue, and gradually exhale deeply. Make sure very deep, slow breath you have to take. Keep practicing and try to understand the technique of the Ujjayi breath. Victorious breath. The breath of the freedom, which and all the suffering of physical world and mental world. Anytime you get tired, you can come back to your chest breathing. Take few seconds of pause. And then again, practicing your Ujjayi breath, Ujjayi pranayam. Go with your own pace. Do not force yourself. This victorious breath is work as a pratyahara, controlling the five senses. Make you become the master of your mind, master of your body. So practice, keep practicing, and don't lose yourself in the thoughts. Keep practicing the Ujjayi pranayam. In order to awaken the prana energy in your body, more you practice, more you will get benefit. Now very slowly come back to your natural breath. Take your own time to complete your practice and come back to your natural breath. Now very slowly bring your awareness towards your natural breath. Bring your awareness towards your natural breath. Now, take a deep, prolonged, slow inhalation, deep, prolonged, slow exhalation. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Now, take a deep, prolonged inhalation for the three time Om and Shanti. Inhale for the Om. Oh. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Feel the vibration and sensation. Join your both palms, rub your palms, place on your eyes. Very slowly while blinking, looking at your palm, gently open up your eyes with a great smile. Om Shanti to everyone. Any doubt, any difficulty related to the Ujjayi Pranayam?
Any particular reason why we concentrated on chest breathing than abdominal breathing here? Because here we are we are working on both sides, right? Like heat is also produced, and then calmness also produced, and then both the pessimistic and decided. So why
yes.
particularly chest breathing, any reason?
Chest breathing, because we are doing, understand one thing, abdominal breathing, when we are practicing it, right, we are putting lots of effort when we are popping out our belly. But in chest breathing, when you do, like when you make the little bit throat contraction, abdominal breathing, you cannot practice. It cannot happen to you. Because that much deep breath, you cannot go for it. Eventually, what happens when you are contracting your throat, you are forcing a little bit, putting the effort to fill your lungs with the air. Yes, slightly movement happen in your abdominal part, but major movement happen in your lungs. Okay, major movement happen in your lungs. So when major part is moving, it's very easily to focus. Yes or no? When major movement is happening somewhere, you can easily focus on that. But slight movement is happening, you cannot focus on that. But unlike the abdominal breathing, we are putting the major movement in the abdominal breathing. But in Ujjayi breath, if we are contracting our, you know, muscles of the throat area, along with your feeling that how your lungs would be filled with the air. Because major movement is happening in your lungs, all the lobes of the lungs, so easily you can concentrate. Mm-hmm. It's very difficult to go with. You can try it. You can see it's working on, because I know that it's very difficult to do the abdominal breathing when you are practicing the Ujjayi breath. Okay, it cannot, because it's required major. I think so long deep breath you required it. Maybe yogi can do, but initial level we cannot practice it. But you can try and share your experience with me. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
But the reason behind of it, that major movement you can feel it more easily, and slight movement is okay to avoid it. Okay.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Welcome, dear. So now time for the assignment. Tomorrow is gonna off for the pranayam class and therapy class and meditation class only. My classes would be off tomorrow, but rest of the class keep going on. So for tomorrow, you have to make the list and talked about the technique and the little bit introduction about the dose and benefit of those pranayam which bring the coolness. Coolness in the body. Are you getting it? Which bring the coolness to the body. So what are those pranayam? You're going to write it down, the names, then their technique and their benefit. Clear to everyone? Good. So this is the assignment for tomorrow class. You're going to practice and going to submit me till Monday. Monday is fine for you, or Sunday. If you do early, that's okay. Sunday you can submit, or the Monday you can submit. So till here, bye-bye.
We don't have to mark you in the mail, right? Only the Vinyasa mail, that is fine. Right?
Yes, that is fine. They're going to share me. Don't worry.
Thank you.
Okay. So bye-bye, dear. Take care of yourself and enjoy these 2 days off. Have a fun, wonderful weekend. And bless you guys. Be happy. Mangal ho. Om Shanti.
Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Yeah. Namaste. Meet you at meditation class. Don't miss it, okay? We still have one class.
Sure.
Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye-bye.